Soldering is an inevitable part of creating a reliable electronic circuitry. Unfortunately, fumes released during soldering are harmful or toxic to humans. It is highly recommended to use a device that can remove these fumes from your working area. Hence, I created a fume extractor which creates an air draft to direct solder fumes to an activated carbon filter and hence filtering the air. So, let's get started. First, we need a fan which will create an air draft. I got a 12 volt DC fan generally used in laptop cooling pads and it needs current of 180 mA. I wanted to power this fan using a USB power supply. I used cable with standard USB type A male port on one end, chopped off other end to expose the 5 volt and ground wires and connected them to XL6009 based boost converter that converts 5 volt USB supply to 12 volt required by our DC fan. But for all practical boost converters, conversion from 5 volt to 12 volt will occur only if input power is greater than output power. In our case for USB driven fan, USB 2.0 can deliver at max 500 mA at 5 volt, giving us 2.5 watt. And USB 3.0 can deliver at max 900 mA at 5 volt, giving us 4.5 watt. Our requirement is of 2.16 watt resulting from multiplying 12 volt and 180 mA as obtained from specification of our fan. I recommend using a USB power bank or USB 3.0 to power this fume extractor, keeping converter efficiency in mind. Once converter was connected to supply cable, I tuned the potentiometer using a screwdriver to get 12 volt output at 5 volt input. Then I connected a freewheeling diode, also called flyback diode, at output of converter. This eliminates sudden voltage spikes seen across an inductive load like fan when its supply current is suddenly reduced or interrupted. Remember to connect cathode of diode at positive terminal of output. Finally, I connected fan at the output of converter. When I powered on circuitry for the first time, it worked flawlessly and was generating good amount of air draft. Once the circuitry was done, I cut out activated carbon filter sheet according to the size of fan. This filter goes at the back of fan. For front side of fan, I decided to use old plastic lid. Took some dimensions and later cut through the lid using hot plate. I made some openings in the lid for air to flow in and also created two holes on top in case I wanted to hang this fan with something. Later I used some M3 nut bolt and washers to attach front lid and back filter with the fan. Assembly looked quite good. At last I glued in converter behind the front panel and secured the wiring using some hot glue. And like that, our fume extractor was done. I hope you like this video. If you have any comments, please leave them below. I have got really interesting videos coming up next, so stay tuned and thanks for watching.